What are the pricing factors that go into insulating your attic with spray foam? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be talking about spray foam insulation in your attic. We're going to talk about some pricing factors. We're going to show you some examples, and then we're going to show you exactly how you can get some budget ranges for your attic. Make sure you stick around all the way to the end so you can get all this info. Don't forget, before we dive into this, you know I need you to go below and hit that thumbs up button. So now we're going to check out some of the factors that will determine this price for you. First, we're going to look at the square footage. Like any spray foam insulation project, square footage will be key. Next, we're going to check out the pitch. How steep is your attic roof deck? Of course, if we are insulating the roof deck, if it's really high and really steep, that's going to drive up the square footage. Lastly, we're going to check out the application. What type of application is the attic going to be like? How thick of foam is going into the attic? Are we putting it on the roof deck or the flat? Is there ventilation involved? Things like that. So these are the things we're going to be checking out, but now let's get into some real world examples. So the first example we're going to look at here is a ranch style house. Now, as you can see, this has a hip roof. Now that means it will be a very low pitch, so it won't add that much square footage if we're doing the roof deck. Now this is a 1200 square foot home. Now again, that 1200 square foot is the living space or the floor plan of the home. And when you're insulating an attic, that will actually come into play pretty close, especially in this hip roof situation. The roof deck itself will be very, very close to that 1200 square foot mark. So if we're looking at this hip roof, keep that in mind. It's going to be low pitched. It's not going to add a lot of square footage, which will help with the cost. So ultimately, the price range we're looking at for this type of install is somewhere between $3,000 and $5,000 for this ranch style hip roof system. So this next example is a Cape Cod style house. Now this attic system can get a little complicated because the inside will be a cathedral ceiling, at least for part of the ceiling. Now if we're looking at this from the inside, again, we may have to go through that ceiling, which may involve cutting strips in the drywall. Again, that can be a little invasive and that can affect the cost a little bit. However, the key thing to keep in mind is you want to be aware of this. This type of project will really require you to be in communication with your contractor because there's going to be a lot of different elements. When you look at this cathedral section, keep in mind that the knee wall section down by the eave, that may be different. That is likely going to be opened up and won't be nearly as difficult to insulate. At the end of the day, we're still going to want to apply that roof deck system of insulation going to that ventless system. So if we're looking at this Cape Cod style house, a price range to insulate this attic will be between $5,000 and $7,000. Of course, the square footage on this home is bumped up a little bit at 1,600 square foot, but all those different complications added in, of course, will drive that price up as well. So again, the price range for this, $5,000 to $7,000 for this Cape Cod style home. So this last example is a colonial style house, and as you can see, the roof pitch on this home is very high. It's a very steep roof. Now why this is important is because it will drive up the square footage for the roof deck itself, which is normally what we recommend insulating. Now when we're looking at that factor, that again, the square footage is up so high because of that steep roof, it may be beneficial to go to a flat install. We may actually recommend putting the foam on the floor of the attic, installing vents around the soffit, just because of that steep roof will drive the price up so much. Now, of course, both systems can work, but that much of a price difference will be a determining factor. Now, this, of course, is a 2,200 square foot home because it is a full two stories. That is the living space. So that 2,200 square foot is not what you will be insulating. Just something to keep in mind. So once again, the price range for this Cape Cod style house will be impacted greatly because we're switching over to a flat system. So the Cape Cod style house price range is going to be between $7,000 and $10,000 to insulate that attic area. So now that you've seen some examples that you could potentially compare your home to get a price range, the better thing to do is go to our website, RetroFoamofMichigan.com, where we have a budget calculator. You can actually plug in the measurements for your home and get a pretty accurate budget range on what your attic would cost to insulate with spray foam. If you want to learn more about the cost of insulating your attic with spray foam, check out the link below. Don't forget, subscribe to our channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.